What's up, guys, and welcome back to Beyond the Void Horror Podcast. My name is Alex, and today we're going to be doing a spoiler-free review of a new movie that just came out on Shudder called La Llorona. Not the Conjuring Universe, Blumhouse, yeah, not that one. A new one that just came out. So let's dive into it. Now, I've reviewed the other La Llorona in the Conjuring universe that I wasn't too thrilled about. Hey, I'm going to go ahead and open the pantry here. La Llorona! And then it was like, oh, hey, what's this over here in the corner? La Llorona! Oh, hey, son, what are you doing under the sheets? La Llorona! La Llorona! La Llorona! I know that's annoying. And it kind of was for me, although I know some people who did enjoy it. Now, this movie is by director Jairo Bustamante, who is a Guatemalan director who made this movie called La Llorona as well. And there's many different variations of the story throughout history. And I am familiar with it because we did an entire episode on our podcast dedicated to the many different stories of La Llorona, which is a story about a woman who drowned her own children and then herself when she realized what she did, and then haunted the man who caused her so much grief by cheating on her with some other woman. Now, there is many different stories across the world, everywhere. Like, this story is one of the biggest folklore legends that you will ever find. And if you are interested in that story, I highly recommend you check out the podcast we did on it. We have actual people who have written stories about it and all the different variations of it. So I will post a link down below so that you can check that out. Now, if you're familiar with that story, and maybe you've even seen the Conjuring Universe one as well, this is not that story. This movie is more of a family drama, slightly supernatural telling of La Llorona in a different sense. This movie surrounds around a dictator, a general who committed genocide during times of war against some of the indigenous people of Guatemala. Now, this is a super political social commentary that uses La Llorona as sort of a mixture hybrid sort of thing in it. For those of you who are looking for the original story, maybe you won't want to see this movie in particular. Now, with that said, I do not want to give this movie a score because I think it's unfair of me to give this one a score, and that is not a cop-out. Because of the political social nature of this story, about this dictator who is getting accused of genocide in court and everything that happens to him, I feel like this is something that is not within my wheelhouse of historical knowledge. If I was Guatemalan, maybe I would understand this story a little bit more. Now, this movie is beautiful. It is really well shot, very well directed. There is no doubt that the person who directed this, Bustamante, has the talent and the chops to do great work. But this, to me, is not horror in the sense that I would pick from a Shudder original. It is, however, very good. But if you're looking for the story of La Llorona, this is going to have a little bit more of a political heaping than it does the La Llorona story. And like I said, it isn't necessarily the story that I was expecting. I did enjoy the movie. I was actually really into it the whole time I watched it. But I don't think I really understand the social commentary, the political commentary, as much as someone that was from Guatemala. If you're looking for the scares and things like that, maybe this isn't for you. If you're looking for a drama political story that uses La Llorona to make a sort of similar story in a way, story about revenge, then this might be for you. There is no doubt that this will win awards for those who understand that commentary more than me. I would feel wrong about giving this a score based on that alone. I will say that it is above average, but on a personal level, it is definitely not what I expected. Doesn't mean you shouldn't check it out and maybe enjoy it as well. I think it's a beautiful story to be told, and obviously it needs to be said. Just on a minor amount of research that I did on this story and some of the troubles that they had with colonization in Guatemala, it is a very poignant telling. But again, as I said, this isn't a story about, you know, horror. This isn't about a woman coming after you to drown you and your children, although there are notes of that within this movie. I don't want to spoil it for you because in case you want to see it, it's not what I expected. And if you're looking for some sort of scary movie about it, about La Llorona, the true story of it, on all the many different variations that there are out there, you're probably not going to find it here. Again, if you want to know the story about La Llorona, it is rich with so much stories, and it's not just some silly legend or folklore thing. There is a lot of people all over the world that know of this story. That's how big this story is. Highly recommend you check that out in the link below. I think most people who are going to want to watch this movie are probably looking for something a little bit different. What do you guys think, though? Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Other than that, we got some more reviews and things coming out. We're going to be continuing the Amityville franchise next week, so I hope you stick around for that. We have a lot of episodes up already as some of the movies that we went through, so check that out. But other than that, thank you so much for stopping by, and as always, long live the void.